श्री संभाजी छत्रपति
Considering active involvement of many Indian companies in the country with multinational companies based abroad, the instances of institutional disputes on various aspects is increasing day by day. So far, individual efforts involving the practicing lawyers was the only avenue available with Indian entrepreneurs. In many cases, the lawyers engaged by the Indian companies may or may not have the adequate knowledge of international arbitration laws, and hence in certain cases the interest of the Indian entrepreneurs was not protected. It was long felt necessary to develop the expertise in international arbitration so that the view of the Indian entrepreneurs is protected. The centre would be able to promote and support research and development of expertise in institutional arbitration at international level so that in due course of time India could be the hub of such activities. The government has very rightly thought of granting the proposed institution an autonomous status to have freedom in taking decisions and enlarging the scope of activities, of course, well within the overall ambit of the bill. The centre would be the first kind in the country and hence would open immense opportunities for the professionals and institutions to develop expertise in international arbitration. In due course, the possibility of establishment of many institutions on international arbitration or adding up a separate department on international arbitration, the existing law institutions cannot be ruled out. The government deserves to be applauded that every effort has been made to keep the proposed centre free from the dominance of administrators. This will help the centre to take the independent decisions in the interest of the specialised subject. I have two suggestions, sir. I request the government through you, sir, to provide a little flexibility in increasing the strength of the members of the centre depending on the workload. Second, my suggestion would be is the arbitration centre, one would be at Delhi and the second is at Mumbai, if we can decentralise it. Sir, experience with the arbitration proceedings till date has shown that a large number of cases still do go back to the normal courts, thus denying the very intent of using an alternate redressal mechanism. Further, there are many complaints regarding that the time of arbitration proceedings too, especially by the international organizations who cite the tardy legal mechanism for not wanting to either come in or deepen the involvement in various initiatives. I am sure that once the NDIS is established, there will be a qualitative improvement to all dimensions of arbitration proceedings, including the various steps in process itself. It will, I am sure, pave the way for many of these cases languishing in various courts of the country to opt for arbitration as a means to arrive at a suitable redressal, thus reducing the backlog. I would like to conclude, sir, I will not take much of time today, but I would like to conclude by saying to have a conducive and healthy atmosphere. The Honourable Minister has rightly stated that India to be an international hub centre, the dispute resolution should come under the New Delhi International Arbitration Centre. That is why I stand to support the bill. Thank you. Sir.